Welcome to our webinar, your speaker for today. So today I'll be sharing with you some of my point of views on how to identify a property hotspot and also one example of such a potential property hotspot after this circuit breaker is lifted. So as property owners, what do we all hope for? I believe we wish to buy, you know, the most undervalued property at the lowest price as possible, as low as possible. And when we want to sell, we sell at one of the highest price, you know, something that's easy to sell in the future, you know. And of course, ideally somewhere near the amenities and good school. But I guess all in all, the main reason is that we hope that our this real estate or asset will increase our wealth and help us earn more money. So is it that easy? You know, every homeowners will wish to be here. This is where all the most profitable deals are, and no homeowners will wish to be in the predicament of having a negative sales. So what can we do to try and minimize this risk? I believe as a homeowner or home buyer or investor, you know, we will have some of the following questions, you know, whether this property have a certain potential, or is this area worth investing in, or if let's say I'm buying for own stay, should I move into this new location? And what are the amenities that's nearby? And what are the upcoming developments that will be happening in the neighborhood? And whether is it the best time for me to buy right now? So I believe that if we have do enough research, you know, by going through data and plans that the government have and the historical happenings on the property market, we can actually minimize such potential risk. So in short, the aim is to find a potentially undervalued area and identify if this area will be the next potential property hotspot. You know, a place that may not have seen much growth at the moment, but there will be various positive factors to push up the price of this area in the future. So how do we identify such a potential property hotspot? You know, a year ago, 99.co actually shared an article online, and they talk about the master plan, how the buyer can look at the master plan to understand it and have an indication of what are the future developments that may impact the value and the quality of living in that area. So in short, it's like having a crystal ball to look at the future. And as some of you may know, the master plan is actually a land use plan that guides Singapore's development in the midterm. So there will be detailed plans to guide the development of area and property in a specific area by having things such as regional highlights. So what you are looking at right now, this is Singapore's Master Plan 2019. And over here, you can see that Singapore is actually separated into five different planning regions. The West, the North, Northeast, East, and of course the Central region. But apart from this planning region, which is used by government planning, in terms of the private residential property market, we also have what is known as a market segment. And Singapore is actually divided into these three market segments. Firstly, the CCR area, where this is where the D9, 10, 11, where the Marina Bay, the downtown core is, and of course, where Sentosa is, followed by RCR, and of course, OCR. And if you can see from this overview, right, of the whole Singapore master plan again, you will realize that the central region is actually where there are two market segments, while the rest of the four planning regions are all lumped into one market segment. Okay, first, if you look at what is shown over here, you'll realize that actually central region where the RCR and CCR have the most number of planning areas, even though they are not the biggest in terms of kilometers, square kilometer. You can see that the biggest area is actually the West region. So this actually make me have these two questions. No, firstly, why are there more planning areas for the central region as compared to the West? And why is it that, you know, the central region is further divided into two market segments while the rest are categorized as OCR, or maybe some buyers, they will say, oh, well, this is where the suburb is. My personal opinion is, let's all think of it this way. If we are right now a foreign investor, let's say we are buying into properties outside of Singapore, for example, UK, I believe one of the main places you'll think of is London. And let's say if Australia, you'll most probably say Sydney or even Melbourne. For Malaysia, you'll talk about KL. And while for a developing country, let's say like Cambodia, you'll say, to play safe, I'll buy into Phnom Penh as a place for investment. So likewise, in the same context, this central region actually represents Singapore. You know, this is where Orchard is. This is where the Central Business District is. This is where Marina Bay is. And for foreigners that is relocating to Singapore or migrating to Singapore, and they have kids, they will also know areas like Bukit Timah where there is a lot of good schools. And what some of the Chinese, they say, this is where the Xie Qi is. And the property there, they call it as Xie Qi Fang. So thus, in terms of all these aspects, I believe this is why the government will have a more precise and detailed planning of the central region. So I believe that changes come in stages, and each region usually will have their own region highlights. So highlights shows the area in the region where the changes will take place in the next few years. So let's take a look at this. This is actually the Master Plan 2014, the previous master plan, you know, where they mentioned about some of the central region highlights. Actually, two areas are stated over here. One is actually Bidadari Housing Estate, and the other one is Paya Lebar Quarters. And if you are familiar with Singapore property scene, you will know that these two areas actually see significant price growth throughout these past few years. Okay. One of these reasons is because you have all these positive news that's out. Like for example, in 2017 for Bidadari area where Woodley MRT station is. So they mentioned about this plot that was won by SPH and Kajima, which will be an integrated development. You know, it will be there will be a bus interchange, there will be shopping malls, and there will be residential on top. So these are some of the news that talk about the positive changes in this area. And likewise, in Paya Lebar area, in 2016, they mentioned about this area called Paya Lebar Quarter, which is just next to Paya Lebar MRT. So it will be the place where there will be this first new mixed development, where the first place to have first grade A office outside of the CBD. And it will also be integrated with residential and retail components and also additional recreational space. So if you look at this price trend, for D13, where Bidadari is, and D14, where Paya Lebar is, this orange line shows the national average. So what it means is that if you have bought something or if you own something during June this period in 2013, by the time you go to December 2013, theoretically, based on Singapore national average, you're looking at about 13.19% capital appreciation. The blue line wise is the specific area, which is D13. And if you can see, based on the same period of time for D13, the growth is actually much more. You're looking at about 27.38%. Likewise, for D14, also the same thing. You see, so in summary, these two areas actually outperform the national average. And let's take a look at some timeline. Okay, the Master Plan 2014 was announced in June 2014, while the draft was announced in November 2013. Then people will ask, hey, how come if that's the case, when this is where it was announced, there don't seem to be an increase. In fact, it seems like the price went down a bit. We will need to understand, just before this period of time, there was actually many rounds of cooling measures so as to prevent, you know, a property bubble from forming in the Singapore real estate scene. And second thing also is the consumers or people at the point of time, they are not as familiar or not as well informed on the master plan compared to nowadays. But when you see significant changes are announced on the news, like for example, just now the slide that I show you, in 2016, they announced the announcement of PLQ, Paya Lebar Quarters. You can see it was in 2016. From then on, you can see the price actually increased by about 21%. Likewise, in the Woodley area, where Woodley Residence is, once they announced that news in 2017, you can see the price also increased significantly. Okay, just to give you some summary on this area's background, 2016, after they announced, in 2017, the residential component of this Paya Lebar Quarter, which is called Park Place Residence, launched its phase one in 2017. And in 2018, it launched its phase two. Likewise, for D13, where Bidadari is, after the announcement was made on this new plot and what is going to be the changes in this area. In the next following year, there was actually two new launches. One is called Park Colonial. It was just before the cooling measure that was announced in 2018. Then followed by another condo new launch called Trevor, and then Woodleigh Residence after that. So you can see that, you know, when there are news and there's new launches, you see the price actually went up quite significantly. Apart from this, if you take a look at transaction volume, you know, the transaction volume also increased significantly with the help of these new launches, you know, injecting new supply. As you can see over here in 2016, after it was announced in 2017 and 2018 for D14, the transaction volume increased quite significantly. Likewise, in this Bidadari area, okay, in District 13, you can see that, you know, after the announcement in 2017, in 2018 and 2019, the following years, the transaction volume also increased quite this significantly. Okay, so what can we learn from these historical happenings, and what are the observations that I've made from the trends since Master Plan 2014 till date? Okay, firstly, significant increase in overall transacted price and volume in the area can be observed when the areas are being highlighted in the master plan region highlights. Okay, number two, major changes in the area are being published on public media after that. So what are the things that are published? Things like, you know, new major infrastructures to be built, enhancement in public transport connectivity, new amenities in the area, you know, things like shopping malls or some civic and community institutions, new recreational spaces, and of course, ample new residential development launches in the area. So over here, this is what I call the two conditions and five major points to be observed and approved that this area became a property hotspot. So right now, the thing is, how do we hunt for the next potential property hotspot? Okay. I will say that learning from history, like what we observed in our Master Plan 2014, we will need to find a location that fulfills that follow that two condition and 5 points as much as possible. So it will be, firstly, the area is being highlighted in the Master Plan region highlights. The second condition is area with major changes in the pipeline based on the Master Plan and other factors, but ideally before it is published on the public media, you know, so that, you know, we can connect the dots and get to know all this info through your research before the mass public get to know about it and spot that particular undervalued area. And likewise, the 5 points to look out for is things like, you know, new amenities in the area, new recreational spaces, the new major infrastructures that's going to be built, the enhancement in public transport connectivity in the area, and of course, ample new residential development in the area. Okay, so with that, let me give you a real-life example of such an undervalued area, which may become the next potential hotspot. Okay, from here on, I will be explaining to you on a step-by-step basis my findings and my own analysis on all the news and facts, and see if it fulfills my two conditions and 5 points, so as to come to a conclusion if this place will potentially be a property hotspot in the future. And let me bring you your focus to this Bukit Timah planning area. Okay, as you can see over here, Bukit Timah planning area is a place that is of lower density in the central region. One of the main reasons is because there's many landeds and a lot of GCBs area. And of course, one of the most green area in Singapore, because this is where Bukit Timah Nature Reserve is. Now let's take a look at central region highlight for this current master plan, which is Master Plan 2019. Why do I say that there's such a potential hotspot will be in Bukit Timah planning area? This is because of these few reasons. Firstly, you see over here, this is Beauty World MRT station. It is highlighted in this region highlights. Second thing, this one is the Bukit Timah Rochor Green Walk. This is for the government is talking about more spaces for fun and leisure. So this is running along the whole stretch of Bukit Timah Road. And the third is this. This is actually Holland Plains. Right now it's not yet developed, but this will be a place that the government is looking to redevelop and enhance in the future. And these three areas are all in this Bukit Timah planning area. Okay, for all planning areas, right, there are what we call sub-planning zones. You know, and Bukit Timah planning area consists of eight such planning zones. And generally, you can see that they are all zoned this color, which means residential. You know, and the prestigious schools are all along this road. This is where Bukit Timah Road is. And the downtown line also run along this road. Okay, but if you realize in this whole Bukit Timah planning area, there is one, this sub-planning zone that is a bit more colorful, and that is Anak Bukit. So there's a lot of light blue, which means mixed development. Dark blue is commercial, which is like eateries or even malls. In fact, a lot of my clients and friends that stay in the Hillcrest, Coronation, or even Swiss Club area, they did mention that they usually frequent this Anak Bukit area because the kids have their tuition there, the music lesson there, and they buy their groceries there. Plus, there's a lot of good food and eateries in that area. So in a way, this Anak Bukit area become like the unofficial town center of Bukit Timah planning area. And this is the place that we will be looking at. Okay, so this one is the sub-planning zone of Anak Bukit. And on the right, this is what we call by district. And this is actually District 21. Okay, interesting thing about D21 is District 21 is segregated into two market segments. Firstly, OCR, and the other part is RCR, which is in the central region. So why is that so? This is because Beauty World MRT, where this is actually belonging to the Anak Bukit sub-planning zone, which belongs to the central region planning. Okay, it's important to know all this because, like what I mentioned earlier on, detailed planning is done in a smaller area, and this is one example. So let's take a good look at this beautiful vicinity. Okay, this is roughly about 2.5 square kilometer, and in terms of our walking distance and stuff, this is beautiful MRT station. Over here is the currently Bukit Timah Community Center. Behind this is a new launch called Daintree Residence. So if you walk this way up to Beauty World, it takes you roughly 6 to 7 minutes, or about 500 to 600 meters. And to further orientate you some more, this zone SE is for education. And this is where Pei Hwa Presbyterian, one of the good schools, is in Singapore. Then you have this big plot called Subject to Detailed Planning in light blue. It's actually zoned for mixed development, but right now it's an open field, okay, which is this part. And over here, actually, right now they are building, they have already built a new show flat for an upcoming launch called Verdil. And right behind, which is this part, is actually an open space car park. And over here, this is one of my favorite places. This is called Chong Ching Nam Road. This is where a lot of good food are, you know, different type of cuisines. And over here are two of the older shopping malls in Singapore. One is Bukit Timah Shopping Center and Beauty World Center. And over here, this big plot, zone 3.0 light blue. Right now, there's actually a lot of construction works. If you drive past Upper Bukit Timah Road, you will see a lot of road construction. And directly inside, there is this vacant nursing home. It used to be a nursing home. Now it belongs to state land. And lastly, this red color here is actually Bukit Timah Wet Market and Food Center. Okay, so now roughly you have an idea of how this place is. And this, what you're looking at right now is what I call the master plan transformation. On my left, what you're looking at is my previous master plan 2014. And on my right is draft master plan 2019. All the places that you see that I've circled are actually changes in the land usage. And it is actually very rare for such a small area to have so many change in land usage. Okay, two notable ones you can see. These two on the left, okay, this is zoned for schools or educational institution in Master Plan 2014. But when it go to draft Master Plan 2019, they became residential plot. Okay, next, this one, you see a H red color. This is actually meaning healthcare and medical. So most probably was zoned for a hospital. And this purple one will be zoned for hotel. And these two plots are right now combined into one big plot of a mixed development, meaning to say there'll be shopping malls and residential component in this area. Okay, after this, the draft master plan, they came to what we call the confirmed master plan, which is the master plan 2019. There were still further changes. Number one is, you see, these three small plots of subject to detailed planning is combined into one bigger plot, which is roughly about 250,000 square feet. And over here next to it, there's one plot of residential with commercial only on the first floor. It's being converted also into a mixed use. And this one will be also another new launch that's coming up in this area. Last year, earlier last year, actually, URA did out this draft master plan 2019 exhibition. And over at the exhibition, I saw this. This is the government's artist impression of the future landscape of Beauty World. And this one is actually where Beauty World MRT station is. You see, there's everything is talking about the future. So all these are actually signs of concrete plans by the government. And what I have shown in the previous few slides actually have fulfilled my first condition, where it's an area under the master plan region highlights. So let's analyze this area thoroughly and see if it meets the second condition on the area of major changes in the pipeline, and ideally before it's published on the public media, and also the 5 points that I mentioned to look out for. Okay, in terms of the 5 points, number one, we will be talking about new amenities in the area. Again, based on doing what I saw in Draft Master Plan 2019 exhibition, they mentioned Beauty World as an integrated amenities area. Okay, there are all these red dots. I'm not very sure if you all can see very clearly on your screen. This, if I zoom out, you can see it's actually where Bukit Timah Community Building is. It's what they identify as an integrated amenities. And apart from that, you can see this light yellow. This actually means existing housing. While Jalan Jurong Kechil here, where it's dark yellow, it is what is zoned for proposed housing. And that's why you see the two plots zoned for educational previously is being converted into residential plots, because there will be potentially new housing supply over here in the further future. Also, when we talk about here, just now I mentioned about this Bukit Timah Community Club right over here. It will be moved to where Bukit Timah Food Center is in the future, and it will be a one-stop integrated facility. So it will have the community club plus the market and the hawker center being integrated into it. They will also have new amenities such as a community library and elderly facility, and also a dual usage indoor sports hall. So this indoor sports hall will be used by the public together with the students of Pei Hwa Presbyterian. And in fact, this news was already out in August 2019. So my point number one that I mentioned is checked, and it's even announced on the public media. So let's take a look at number two, which is new recreational spaces. Okay, when we talk about Beauty World or Bukit Timah area, many people will think of green spaces because this is where Bukit Timah Nature Reserve is. And apart from this existing Bukit Timah Nature Reserve and also Bukit Batok Nature Park, which is nearby, Rifle Range Nature Park is also undergoing further enhancement. And there will be an upcoming Bukit Timah Rochor Green Walk, as per mentioned. And also, there will be a future Green Promenade Walk in this Beauty World vicinity. So with all these green spaces in and around this area, we will see an improvement in lifestyle, and generally, it will attract more people to stay in this area as the place becomes more livable, being more integrated with convenient amenities and a biophilic lifestyle. And in fact, some of the news are already out. Like in April 2019, they mentioned about the enhancement in Rifle Range Nature Park. And some of the news actually start to flow in for this nature park as early as in the September 2018. Next, in September 2019, they mentioned about this Bukit Timah Rochor Green Walk, which will be about 11 kilometers long, running from the rail corridor where Beauty World is, all the way to Kallang Riverside, running past Rochor area. So this is also announced on Straits Time. So apart from all this green, one more unique thing about Beauty World is the name itself. Beauty World, as some of the older generations will know, they bring back a lot of memories, and it's something of a heritage. And in fact, again, in the Draft Master Plan 2019 exhibition, they mentioned Beauty World as one of the 19 designated identity nodes by URA. And they also mentioned about the former Bukit Timah Fire Station and Beauty World to be transformed into gateways for surrounding nature and heritage attractions. And there will be more street level activities and landscaping to improve the walking experience of this area. Okay. And in fact, over here, they also had during the exhibition an artist's impression of a future development in beauty world. And for this, right, there are not much news out yet at this moment. But you can see from here, my point two is also checked. And the good thing is, some of the news are not out. Okay, number three, we talk about new major infrastructure to be built. Okay, you see my this title is Beauty World Integrated Transport Hub. Okay, why do I say that? Okay, as mentioned over here, this plot of land was previously zoned for a healthcare and medical and a hotel, and it's being combined to become a mixed-use land. And actually, in government's land of confirmed list of government land sales program, there's only three plots of land that's under this confirmed government land sales program for the first half of 2020. And there is only one government land sales site that is under central region, which is Jalan Anak Bukit, which is this site, which is about 350,000 square feet. Okay. And it is also the only mixed development in the RCR to be launched also. And it will be integrated with a bus interchange. Okay. Will provide amenities for commuters and residents. So what is this integrated transport hub? Yeah, I did some read up and things, and I realized that one of the definitions for integrated transport hub in Singapore is they are fully air-conditioned bus interchange, which is seamlessly linked to MRT station at adjoining commercial developments such as shopping malls. And in fact, there are quite a few in Singapore already, and Beauty World here, this is the new plan of what is going to happen in this area. Actually, in November 2019, there was a similar integrated transport hall, integrated development that was being launched, but it was in the OCR, which is the northeast of Singapore, called Sengkang Grand Residence. And actually, if you take a look, they sold 216 units during the launch weekend out of the 280 units released. And actually, it's very well received. The land cost we're looking at the point of time was $923 per square feet per plot ratio. But if you take a look at the average price, they sold at an average of $1,700 per square foot for a 99-year leasehold in the OCR. Okay, and I did a further dig into the caveat and realized that the highest PSF transacted is 1898 PSF for a one bedroom, which roughly costs you $960,000. In fact, in RCR, you still can find some new launches that is around this price point or even lower. But what is the reason for this type of price acceptance? I believe one of the reasons is because of all these integrated amenities, and they are all announced. You know, like they mentioned that there will be a retail mall, hawker center, community club, childcare center, and a bus interchange. So buyers know that these are all being announced already, and it will definitely happen. And thus, they will have more confidence and willing to pay a certain premium for it. And can you imagine for this plot that is in the Anak Bukit, it's also going to be an integrated development, but this time around in RCR region, okay, within 1 kilometer from good school and amenity. Plus, over here, this area is the traditional rich man area. So how much do we think the potential selling price will be? Of course, it depends on the bidding price by developer. But as a mega integrated landmark development in this area, right, it will definitely potentially be heavily contested. Okay, so apart from this, right, another place that I would like to highlight is this potential landmark building in the further future. Okay, over here, this plot you see is subject to detailed planning on top of Beauty World MRT. Actually, there is another place that is of a similar topography and things have happened. Okay, it is actually in the Bidadari Estate. If you take a look at Master Plan 2008 of Bidadari area, you can see over here, subject to detailed planning, directly on top of the MRT station. Over here is Ule MRT station. Okay, and by the time it changed to the next Master Plan 2014, you see the plot ratio is out. A lot more plannings are out. And this is the place that we all know now, known as Woodley Residence. And in June 2017, like I mentioned earlier, it was already announced. The land cost is about 1,100 plus. It's going to be a landmark Bidadari project. And of course, after this is mentioned in June 2017, again, you see what I mentioned earlier on. After 2017, the price increased significantly. Okay, this orange line that you are looking at is actually private residential property within 1 kilometer of Woodley MRT station. The blue line that you are looking at is within 1 kilometer of Beauty World MRT station. And if you realize a decade ago, 10 years ago, you know, Beauty World area's average per square feet is actually much higher than Woodleigh, as you can see over here. But due to many new launches and the changes that was announced since 2014 onwards going up, you can see that the price of Woodleigh site have actually overtake this Beauty World area. And thus, this is also another reason why I find that this vicinity is most probably undervalued. Okay, but I believe for this plot that is directly above Beauty World MRT station, it will not be launched so soon, as there will be still plans underway. That's why it's still subject to detailed planning. And potentially, it means that there will be positive news for this area beyond 2022 to 2025. And why do I say that? Because at this moment, apart from this subject to detailed planning, right, there is actually, like what I mentioned just now, a new shop flat on part of this plot, which is the upcoming new launch called Verdale. And an off-site show flat will usually remain in the area for the next year or two. Thus, my conclusion that this plot will be released much later. And to me, it's a positive news as it means that the value of this area may continue to go up further with even more news in the future. So again, number three, what I've mentioned is all checked. And we go to number four. Enhancement in public transport connectivity. So apart from public transport connectivity, I believe in terms of transport connectivity for people that drive is also important. And actually since 2015, again, this area, this is the integrated transport hub port. Actually, the signs were there much earlier, but a lot of us didn't realize that they are doing a lot of road expansion works. Okay, and a lot of infrastructure support have been underway, such as the road widening, you know, they will be adding new cycling tracks and also covered linkways to MRT station. And if you see, even at Jalan Jurong Kechil, over here, just at the corner is where Beauty World MRT station exit C is, and over here is this Bukit Timah Community Center right now, where it's just in front of Lane 3 residents. So this whole area, Jalan Jurong Kechil, right, they were actually two lanes on each side. And actually, they have been widened to three lanes. Plus, you can see that covered walkway from the Toei Estate HDBs, right, to the MRT station is already completed. So these are all the improvement works they have realized that they have gone through. Another thing when we talk about public connectivity is definitely the MRT station. And as most of us know, there's a new Cross Island Line which was announced in January last year. Okay, and this one will have actually, the first when the announcement came out, it caused a lot of positive impact to property sales in some of the area. Okay, phase one of this Cross Island MRT line actually mentioned about this one of these MRT stations is called Serangoon North MRT. And when this news was announced, it actually benefited two new launches within 1 kilometer of this MRT station. One is called Affinity at Serangoon, and the other one is called Garden Residence. So if you see on my next slide, if I don't remember wrongly, these two new launches was launched during Q2 of 2018. And you see about 170 units sold, including resale in this area. Okay, these are all within 1 kilometer of Serangoon North MRT station's private residential. Of course, usually after a new launch, it will slowly taper down. And that's why you see in terms of transaction volume, it went down a bit. But when you see this announcement on Cross Island Line Phase 1 being announced in Q1 2019, you see this very significant increase in the total transaction volume as more people have confidence in the area and know about all these changes that's coming out, even though they were mentioning that the MRT line will only be completed in 2029. So of course, right now, they have only mentioned for the Phase 1 of the Cross Island Line. And based on LTA, they mentioned that Phase 2 will go past Bukit Timah to Clementi, followed by West Coast and Jurong. And the completed line will be something like that, stretching from the west where Tuas is, all the way to the east where Changi Airport is. But right now, after 1 year, they didn't seem to have mentioned anything about Phase 2 yet. One of the main reasons is because of this Central Catchment Reserve alignment. So they were thinking whether to cut through the Central Reserve or to make a detour. And actually, because of that, the LTA engaged a third party to do an environmental impact assessment report. And by December 2019 last year, they confirmed that the Cross Island Line will be taking the direct route from Sin Ming to the beginning of Bukit Timah area. So now let's take a look at the master plan again. And this time around, I incorporated some land zone. Over here, you see is GCB areas, good class bungalow area and landed housing. Okay, and if I superimpose the work site for this Cross Island Line MRT station. And of course, you will see King Albert Park MRT, Beauty World MRT station, and this future integrated transport hub. Okay, the idea is, do you think that the train line will be running down here directly across or going around? Okay. When doing phase one, they announced all these things. The LTA actually mentioned that there will only be partial acquisition and will not have major effect on residents and landowners. And for this area, you're not talking about normal landed, you're talking about good class bungalows. So I believe this place where the top 1% of Singaporeans are living in, the chances to run across seems to be quite low. And if history serves me well, let's talk about, if we talk about Downtown Line or North East Line, you realize a majority of them run past major road so as to prevent land acquisition. And there's a possibility that it may run along here instead. And if you take a look at Singapore Rail Network 2040, right? This is by LTA, their so-called transport plan. This area is where we are talking about. Okay, if I zoom it up, you will see this, okay, over here. And if I superimpose the master plan land usage to let you have an idea of how the land usage will be. And then this is the work site. Okay, this is where Downtown Line is. And over here is the east-west line. So we know that over here, this is where Beauty World MRT, King Albert Park, and the future integrated transport hub is, and Clementi MRT station is here. Okay, if you take a closer look at this infographic, you will see that the train lines are actually quite accurate based on the actual map. And this curve of the east-west line and the intersection of this Downtown Line is actually Clementi MRT. And in fact, a lot of people have known that when they talk about Cross Island Line, cutting past Bukit Timah and Clementi, the MRT interchange for this east-west line and Cross Island Line will most probably be Clementi because there's only one MRT station called Clementi. But when they say they mention that they'll cut through Bukit Timah, that means it will intersect with Downtown Line. In fact, there's no MRT station called Bukit Timah. Over here, look, is Beauty World, followed by King Albert. Going down some more is 6th Avenue, and going out is Hillview. There's no MRT station called Bukit Timah. But if you take a look right now from a drastic land change, it becomes a future integrated transport hub. I guess the thing that is not yet announced and worth us speculating and make a guess is, where will this Cross Island and Downtown Line interchange be located? So these are all news that is not out yet, but we can predict an enhancement in public transport connectivity in this area in the future. The last point, number five, ample new residential developments launched in this area. Okay, to share with you some history, let's take a look at this site, which is the Toh Tak site where Daintree Residence is right now. Okay, actually, this site was heavily contested in 2017. It was the first GLS site to be launched in this whole area after quite a few years. And they actually have 24 different developers bidding for this land. Okay, just for comparison context, this is the second highest number of bidders on a particular plot since 2009. And one thing to note is the top three bids are actually less than 6% of each other. Okay, all these exceeded property consultants' expectation. They were estimating about 8 to 16 bidders and the highest bid of not more than $750 per square feet per plot ratio. But if you take a look here, the top 10 bids, they are all above this estimation of $750 per square feet per plot ratio. And this to me is an indication that many developers do have a positive outlook of this area, but it was actually quite undervalued. And this was in 2017. Now let's take a look at from 2018 right now till now. Okay, you can see this is part of the Bukit Timah planning area. And all these orange ones are actually new launches, projects that's already launched. The red ones are those is not yet launched. And then you see this is subject to tender. And if I circle this, you can see just within this Anak Bukit area, you are looking at three current new launches, three more upcoming new launches, and one more site for tender in June. Okay, these seven developments add up, they'll have less than 3,000 new units in the area. So some people will say, hey, will there be an oversupply? My personal take is most probably not, but we will be having ample supply. Okay, Why do I say that? We know that some of these developments in Singapore, some new launches, they are mega development whereby a single development alone will have 1,000 to 2,000 over units. But one good thing about this Bukit Timah characteristic is development here are less dense. And so we see there are more new sites, but lesser units per site. This one will cater to different buyer having different needs. And because of the different development size, a different design concept, and also the total number of units, and this will have a healthy competition, because different concept and different size will have different price point, and it may help to push the price of this area on a steadier pace. Okay, imagine right now if I have a property in this development, and 5-10 years down the road, I want to sell, and this development has, let's say, 1,500 units. If I want to sell it urgently, one thing that I will need to do is lower down the price. Why? Because all the units are enjoying the same facilities. The finishing is the same. And for me to get it off the market as soon as possible, the fastest way one may do it is the price. We lower down the price. And for that, the buyer will be choosing more on the price. But when you have over here, different developments with different unit size and everything, the buyers will not be able to just compare purely on a price point, because what? There's different style, different size, and it will cater to their different needs. So they will no longer be able to compare based on price point. But what are the facilities are we getting? What are the finishing that we're getting? Is it near to this good school or what? Plus, with smaller units, lesser units in all these sites, that means that the launches will and the future completion will be staggered, and they will not be out in the market together. And this will help to steady the supply that's being released into the market. And all these are actually what I call push factors. They may help to push price upward in the future. So in summary, we have seen all these news that I have consolidated that has already announced. Yes, many news have come out on this area, but at this moment, I feel that not many people have connected the dots. Plus, data from the master plan and LTA transport plan, right? It seems to show that there will be more news out. So this is a place that have quite a few of this, what we want to have, ideally before it's published type of condition. And what will be two of the most possible big news that will come out? I will say one is this Cross Island Line Phase 2 MRT stations, and the other one is the tender date and the concept for this integrated transport hub. Like what I mentioned, we want this area to be having news that is not out yet. But which one will come out first, if you ask me? I will say my own personal take before this COVID-19 is, I believe that ideally the MRT station will be announced first, followed by the date of tender for this government land sale site. Because if I'm the government, I will wish that I can attract more bids from developers, let more developer be interested, and potentially have a higher bid price, because they know that, where is the MRT interchange for the Cross Island Line. But of course, this is just my personal opinion, and we can only monitor right now, but I still remain hopeful that this may be the case. So, coming back to all this, does Beauty World this area fit what I mentioned as a future property hotspot criteria and fit these two conditions and fine points? Let's recap. Number one, area being highlighted in the master plan region highlights, we have that check. No, areas with major changes in the pipeline, ideally before it's published, we have this condition also. And I have shared with you on the new amenities in the area, the new recreational spaces, the new major infrastructures to be built in this area, and also the talk about this enhancement in the public transport connectivity, and finally, ample new residential launches in the area. Okay, so with all this, for me, I find that this area is actually undervalued at the moment, and not a lot of people are paying attention to this area yet, from my experience and what I have seen on the ground. So this is actually just one example of how I spotted a potential property hotspot, because when we know, we want to say property hotspot, it must be something that is news are out already. But when all these news are out, it may be a bit too late. So potential hotspots are usually a place that most probably will be currently undervalued. And actually, you can try and explore on URA Master Plan and try to hunt for under property hotspot. But of course, all this takes quite a bit of time and research and maybe some sensitivity to the market. And with this, we come to the end of my webinar. Thank you for the past 40 minutes with me, and I hope you all have some takeaway from this session.